Hi, this is part two of two when it comes to my segment on linting and uglifying Apache Cordova code. So in the previous tutorial, I showed you how to uglify your Apache Cordova code, making it harder for malicious users to gain access to, as well as making it more efficient to run on your mobile device. So part two is going to be a little more complex. It is on the subject of linting, where your code will be checked for errors before you build. So that way, any kind of syntax or typos will be caught, and you won't have to struggle so hard in the debug process. It's a good idea that you first are familiar with creating Apache Cordova hooks before you proceed with this. I do have another tutorial floating around with a basic introduction to Apache Cordova hooks. And hooks are just scripts that are run at some point in the build process. So with that said, I'm going to go ahead and continue exactly from where we left off in the previous video. Let's begin. So I already have our project created, and I'm in there with my terminal. What we need to do is we need to install two packages with the node package manager because they are dependencies for linting. The first package that we want to install is JSHint. So we can do that by doing the following. And if you get an error like I did, chances are there's some kind of permission issue. Because you're running on a Mac or Linux operating system, just go ahead and throw a sudo in front of that and it should take care of the problem. Alright, so we just installed JSHint. Now we need to install async. So we're going to do... Alright, so the reason why we're installing async is because we need a way to be able to loop through the files that we're linting and be able to stop our build process should errors be determined. And that can't be done with a normal list iteration because we have a lot of asynchronous stuff happening. So with that said and done, we're going to go ahead and create a script. We're going to go ahead and create a new directory in our hooks called before prepare. And unlike the Uglify, this one's going to happen before the preparation starts to save time. So let's go ahead and create a file. This is going to be our script file. What we're going to do is we're going to call it 02jshint.js. And by default on Mac and Linux operating systems, it's probably going to have incorrect file permissions. We need to be able to execute the script with execute permissions. So let's go ahead and change that with a chmod. All right, now it's all set up and ready to run. All right. So at this point in time, we need to go ahead and we need to create this hook. So let's start it like the following. We're requiring a few dependencies here, the file system, path. JSHint. And async. Alright. With that done, we need to go ahead and define which folders we want to be linted. So we're gonna only include one for this process. You can go ahead and do whatever you want beyond this. We're going to only lint the JavaScript directory. So now we need to make a loop. We're going to loop through each of the folders, and we are going to run a process files function that we're going to soon make. And that's going to go something like this. So what's going to happen with this is it's going to go through each of the root www folder, and it's going to go www, and then JavaScript. So anything in our JavaScript directory, which in our situation is only index.js. So now it's time to go ahead and create that function called process files. Alright, so it's going to look like this with zero. Now we're going to read the directory. Alright. So the first thing we want to do when we read the directory for each of the files is we want to check to see if an error was returned. This would be if there was a problem reading the directory. Then we're going to return out of it if there's an error. But if there isn't one, let's go ahead and now we're going to loop through each of the files in the list, and this is where the async comes in, because the regular for each does not cut it. So we're going to do the following: async each series, alright, so we're doing each series because we want each iteration of this loop to wait before until the previous iteration has completed. And this is because we have a lot of like promise functions that we're going to make where they won't necessarily finish in sequence by default. So the loop might finish before the iteration, before everything in the iteration has completed. And we don't want that. We want to make sure that the iteration is completed before we proceed. So let's go ahead and continue. We need to further construct our file path. So what we're doing here is because each of the files is the base name, we need to append it to the directory, which would be www and then js, because we want the full path of the file. The next thing we want to do is we want to check to see if it's a file or if it's a directory. Alright, so now we can do if stat not stat is directory. So we're going to say if it's not a directory, then we're going to process it. Because what we're going to do is we're just going to skip over every directory. If we were making a more complex example, we might offer some kind of recursion to be able to look through each of the directories inside of a directory. But to keep things simple, we are not going to do that. So we've determined it's not a directory. So we're going to do the following. Oops. So we're going to check to see if the extension is JavaScript, because that's the only type of file that we care about. And if it is, we're going to call this function that we have yet to make. It's going to be called lint file. And then we're going to pass it the file, and we're going to handle a callback. Alright, so in here, if an error was discovered, we're going to add to the error count. And then we're going to call the inner callback. By calling the inner callback, that tells the async that we are completely done with the current iteration. So that means it can move on to the next list item. But we're not done yet. We also need to add else to each one of these, because we need to be able to tell it that we're done, even if we run into a file that's not JavaScript and is a directory. We don't want it to just hang. So we need to do the following. All right. And now we got to handle the error callback. Well, the whole async has completed. So not just a single iteration of the async, the entire async. And in here, we want to say if error count is greater than 0, because we found a file with at least one error in it, then we want to do process.exit1. And what that means is we found an error. We do not want to proceed building our project. Stop building. Just stop everything so that way we can correct our errors. Otherwise, it'll just continue and it's more of a warning. I like to treat this as not a warning, but an actual error. It's something to act upon. So the next thing we want to do is we want to create the function for lint file that we're going to be using. So let's go down and start with the following. We're going to pass it a file and a callback. So we're going to start by reading the file. And if there was an error, we're going to catch it. Otherwise, we're going to proceed. And in this case, we're going to start calling the JSHint functions and get down to business here with the linting. Alright, so if the JSHint returns true for the data that we pass in, the data being the file content, so all of our JavaScript code, if it returns true, that means there was no errors found. So we're going to say it. And we're going to say false on the callback because there was no errors. However, we're going to do an else. And that means that JSHint returned false and there were errors found. So we're going to spell it out here. All right, so the output, we're going to see what the output is for JSHint. Then we're going to see what the errors are for JSHint. And now we're going to loop through each of the errors for the particular file that failed. We're going to say which line number it is. The character. the reason. And then we're going to display the evidence. These are all part of the JSHint package that we installed, and documentation can be found on it if you go to the JSHint website. Alright, so we just printed it out. Now what we want to do is we want to return true in the callback because it did find errors. And again, this is the callback that it's referring to, has error, and in this case, has error was true, so it increments the counter for total errors found. So if we have two files and both files had errors, then error count would be 2. So it's the error count is per file. That's all we care about, that a file had errors. And that's enough to where we would cancel the build process. So with that said and done, let's go ahead and test out this code. So in our project, let's go ahead and type in Cordova prepare. And for some reason, there is an error. So let's check it out. Folders to process is undefined. Did I have a typo somewhere? Yeah, so I do have a typo. I forgot the S. So let's try that again. I have another error. I'm guessing that I made another typo somewhere. It says, no such method read file. And that is on line 50. I have a feeling that it's just an issue with case sensitivity. Let's try that, see if it works. It did work. All right, so let's look at our output here. We can see that it scanned one file and it has no errors in it. So let's go back and let's go ahead and create an error. This isn't, for example, let's go ahead and remove the semicolon on this line. All right, I saved it, and we're going to run it again. All right, so I have a different error in the hook. I probably made another typo. Let's check it out. Errors is not defined on line 62. That's because I called it error. So let's fix that. Try it again. I have a whole mess of errors here, so looks like I made plenty of typos, which happens to everyone. I fixed my typo again. Let's run it. Alright, this time it detected that there was an error in my index.js. It says I'm missing a semicolon at line 22. Let's validate this. Yep, I'm missing a semicolon at line 22. And it also says that the hook failed with error code 1. That's because we stopped the build process. All right. So, let's clear that. Let's see what happens when we try to actually do a build. Still, it fails to build. So let's go ahead and fix our error and save it. And we're gonna try to build it again. You know what? Let's do Cordova prepare just to check. Yeah. So it's good to go. We're doing a build and it's succeeding this time. No problems. So going back to our code here, just like that, we implemented a way to lint our JavaScript for errors, And believe me, as you can see, I have plenty of typos in my code when I program. And it's a lot less painful to use a linter than it is to go back using a debug console trying to figure out where your errors are. I highly recommend that you do both linting and uglifying of your code, just like I demonstrated in this video as well as my previous video, part one, as it'll offer a great deal of help for you. And this will work for Apache Cordova, PhoneGap, and Ionic framework.